Hello everyone, welcome back to a brand new video, a brand new review. Today we have another pair of Jordans. If you want to hit that subscribe button, I would really appreciate you get to hang out with me on a regular basis, and of course we're doing all kinds of really cool reviews over here on the channel. Today we're taking a look at the Jordan 3 Fire Red Denim SE. Here we go, we got a new box. We've got a two-tone Jordan box. You can see it's kind of switching it up a little bit. You've got the white on one side and this kind of elephant print with a little bit of a blue tinge on it. You've got the red Jumpman logo, the sizing tag that reads Air Jordan 3 Retro SE White Fire Red Black. So let's pop open the pair of sneakers, and again you are met with some more of that paper on the inside with that same print, which is pretty much the main driving factor of this pair of sneakers, the Jordan 3 Fire Red Denim. I got the loser version, though there was a Japan exclusive that released alongside this. The main driving factor of that pair being the CO.JP branding that you find around the sneaker. Pretty much an identical pair to that one, however, it just has a few different logos that we'll get to in a second. So this version, essentially the GR version or the globally available version, obviously had a much higher stock number, and that Japan exclusive, like I said, was only available in Japan, was of course a lot lower in terms of stock number. So this pair actually released on August the 8th over here in the EU and won't see a worldwide release up until August the 27th. These retail for £170, or about $200 if you're out in the US, and of course right now they're sitting at about that retail price. I mean, I think you can still find these in stock at a few different places over here in the EU. Now, as for that Japan exclusive, that's about at least $40 more expensive than this. But essentially, it's exactly the same thing. You're literally going to be paying for the exclusivity and, of course, Japanese branding that you find on the sneaker. That's about it. Essentially, it's the same materials, the same look, the same everything. These are relatively similar to what you would find on the Jordan 3 Fire Red that released back in 2018, but there are some key differences on this pair. The leather on these is actually really nice. It feels really soft and really smooth, and of course we'll do the, you know, the test of when you press it and you get the wrinkles around it. So it is a really soft, good feeling leather material that you get with this pair. Toe box is covered in that really nice leather material, and of course as for the mud guard, this is where you start to see those key differences. So this mud guard does come in that same elephant print, however is made up of this Japanese denim. Now, it is not necessarily Japanese denim, however, that's what it was inspired by. It was inspired by Japanese denim and has a very, very close look to that elephant print, of course, to keep it somewhat similar to what you would find on a regular Jordan 3 model. So you find the first touch of this just around in a very small bit, I think a lot smaller than what you would find traditionally in terms of the elephant print on a Jordan 3. Moving up from the toe box, you get this very lightly perforated tongue, which is very nice and soft, just like the rest of the leather on this sneaker. It comes with a set of white laces and no other laces included with this pair. Like usual, you have your extra eyelets on either side, and that has a little bit of red. Moving up from that, you get your second look at this denim material. Again, coming in this nice kind of bluish tint. It's almost like a very dark bluish color. And as for the top of the tongue, you get, again, really nice leather feeling material. It's very soft, and you have the embroidered Jumpman logo in this red color. The back of the tongue comes in all red. And as for the sock liner or the ankle area on the inside, you're getting this black color. The insole on these comes in all white and has the Nike Air branding on the heel portion. Now, this is another place where it differs from the Japan exclusive, which has the co.jp or the co.jp logo right where you find on this version the Nike Air branding. You get some more hits of red with this ankle area. Just on the exterior, you have this lightly perforated red color, and again in that same really soft leather material. And moving to the back of the sneaker, and this is where it gets probably the most exciting thing that you find on it, where it features this clear or semi-translucent, or actually in this case it's almost completely translucent, pull tab area. So for this pull tab bit, you can see you don't have either a Jumpman or a Nike Air branding, you got both. So this is, I think, the first time I've ever seen this, but underneath you have the Nike Air text, and just above that, in that translucent material, you have this plastic Jumpman logo with the Air text underneath. And just underneath that, you get some more of that Japanese denim, or the denim inspired by Japanese denim. And as for the midsole, this time the heel portion comes in black and the rest of the midsole comes in all white. Traction pattern follows that pretty similarly. It comes in completely white with some black elements at the front and the Nike branding at the back, which comes in red. This is almost a take it or leave it colorway for me. However, this denim color that is a little bit darker than you would normally find with a regular elephant print, I think sits really nicely with this sneaker. You know, when I was filming the B-roll and when I was wearing this out in the sun, I was like, you know what? I kind of fell for them just a little bit more, because I think this is a really clean summer colorway. As for sizing and fit on these, they fit me true to size, so that's what I can recommend. Essentially, you do feel like there's a nice amount of movement, of course, because this leather is so nice and soft. You don't feel as stiff as other Jordan models, where the leather is just not as soft as you find on this version. But that pretty much wraps up my thoughts and opinions on the Jordan 3 Denim SE. Now, what do you think about these? Is this something that you are going to grab when it releases globally on August the 27th? Or did you manage to get them over here in the EU on August the 8th? Let me know down in the comment section, and like always, thank you so much for liking, commenting, and subscribing. I'll catch you in the next video, but until then.